Hey guys, so today I'm going to be taking a look at Linux Mint 18 Cinnamon. This is the beta release, so any bugs or anything that I might come across in today's first impressions review, it is possible that they could very well be phased out when it comes to the final release candidate. I've also recorded a version of this review where I cover the Mate version of Linux Mint, and I also cover things like the X apps, so I won't be covering them in this first impressions review. If you want a review of the X apps, then the Linux Mint Mate review will be the place to go for that. So, what's new in Linux Mint 18 Cinnamon Edition? Well, Cinnamon 3.0, X apps, which I've already covered, the new update manager as well, which is pretty good, is a few nice improvements, but it's still as easy to use as ever. And then there's some more theming options, which I will go through as a demonstration. And then some new, nice new backgrounds. So for all intents and purposes, the similarities do seem to be reasonably similar to the Linux Mint Mate edition, with the exception, of course, of the Cinnamon desktop environment. But of course, with the use of X apps, so if I go to accessories and I go to text editor, it should be XED 1.0.5. So it's still the same. So, I mean, like, the majority of the same user experience will apply. You'll be using the same apps and a very similar desktop layout, which, again, you know, my biggest long-term criticism of Linux Mint is, why have two flagship distributions if you're going to try and do the exact same thing with both distributions? It just feels like it's just an unnecessary amount of work. You know, either the Cinnamon or the Mate would work great as a community distribution. I suppose you couldn't do that with Cinnamon, because Cinnamon is actually built and created by the Linux Mint developers. So, in terms of themes, this is the Mint X theme. So in the Linux Mint Mate first impressions demonstration, I showed you the Mint Y theme. This is the default theme for Linux Mint 18, at least this particular iteration of 18, and that's because it seems that there have been a few problems with implementing the Mint Y theme completely correctly on GTK3, which is to be expected. Of course, it is beta. They might work these out for the final release candidate, or they might, of course, stick with the Mint X theme, which looks fine. Like, I think this is a great look. It's not the best looking theme out there, but it looks like the theme of a professional, well put together distribution. So this is the Cinnamon menu. It's all pretty straightforward. You've got your favorites on the side. You've got your applications here. You can search, of course, at the top. So if we go into system settings, and of course we have the application launcher as well. Not the application launcher, the software manager. So again, we've got a very similar Mate style control panel, which works. So I can go into themes. Of course, I am running this in a virtual machine, so expect a significant delay in performance. So again, this is the exact same software manager as we saw in the Mate edition, and then the feature apps are all the same, and they have all the same software reviews, I believe, which is, again, it's a very useful, very straightforward, very easy to use software manager. Has a few, you know, it's very easy to use, very straightforward. It gives you solid, detailed descriptions for the software. Give version numbers. I could do with a little bit more information, but that's just me as a power user, and maybe Linux Mint is, you know, it doesn't really cater to power users, just people that need an overview of information by the looks of it. People that just want to get the job done and aren't too fussed about the logistics of it all. Okay, so then here's an example of the comments down there, which I think are really quite useful, because when you're looking at software and you're not really too familiar about what the software does or how good the software is, it's great to have other people's opinions. So I have changed the icons to the Mint X tier. One of the things I really love about the Mint X theme, you can change the color of the highlight of the theme. So if you like red or purple, so I've got a teal one here. Obviously, the default is green, but it gives you a lot of customizability options just with the icon theme alone. Same thing with the controls. And the desktop. So the theming is done pretty easily. I like it when like the way that Martin XFCE do it, where they just take the GTK theme and then theme everything around the GTK theme with the exception of the window manager. But alas, they do it this way, which for all intents and purposes is fine, because mouse pointers and controls and icons, they transcend all desktop, or not all desktop, most desktops. In fact, some themes do transcend all desktops because they work on Qt and GTK. But the window borders and the desktop themes, they're the two that you need to work out specifically for the Cinnamon desktop. And that it can be a little bit tricky to find Cinnamon themes, because it's one of the, you know, it's a lesser well-known desktop, and it doesn't really have that much third-party enthusiasm for it, which is fine. You can understand it. It's a desktop environment moving into a crowded space. And I think that the Pantheon desktop that comes with Elementary had the right idea, where it's, well, if we're going to design our own desktop environment, let's make it our desktop environment. Let's make it a one-size-fits-all desktop environment that you can't customize, and then some people, you know, so it's beyond breakage from that kind of department. And having administrating computers for other people do accidentally drag icons to the other side of the screen and forget where they are, and they what's my panel doing on the left hand side of the screen, because they haven't locked it and all that kind of stuff. And a lot of these settings are more complicated than they need to be, so it's reasonably simple to change up things in Cinnamon. But you've also got things like extensions, hot corners. I mean, you know, it does seem a little bit like it just seems like, ooh, that desktop has a nice idea, let's bring it into ours. And it does seem that hot corners. I mean, it's useful, I guess, but I don't see that many people using them. In fact, I don't think I know anyone that uses them. I mean, do they need to be there? But for all intents and purposes, there is not that much bloat. Additional stuff that you're sort of wading through to find settings that you want to change. And this is the startup welcome screen. The welcome screen is pretty good. It gives you gets you acquainted with the main things. You can install, of course, proprietary hardware drivers, which is very, very useful, especially if you're new to Linux and you're not really familiar on all the ramifications of proprietary versus open drivers and all that kind of stuff. Comes with the Firefox browser, comes with Pidgin, the Office is LibreOffice. Linux Mint has always been hailed as a distribution that makes solid software choices. This is the VLC Media Player. And that theme's VLC Media Player, for those of you that don't know, is a Qt application designed to work natively with desktop environments like KDE or LXQt, and often don't theme correctly on GTK-based environments. This does. In fact, I think there were some problems with the Mate edition, where the Mint Y theme didn't work with some Qt applications. I think it's Qt5-based applications or Qt4, one of the two. So this review is going to be substantially shorter than my Linux Mint Mate one, simply because I'm not going to be covering X apps, and I'm not going to be covering software upgrade, and I'm not going to be covering almost anything that's not directly the Cinnamon desktop at this stage now, because it's all covered in the other video. Cinnamon desktop, it's a fine desktop, I guess. It's reasonably easy and straightforward to use, but it does seem like a direct stand-in for Mate, and I don't really fully understand why you need a Cinnamon and a Mate and an XFCE. They seem to be, you know, it seems that everything could be done through XFCE, really. Like, there doesn't seem to be... The difference between Mate and XFCE seems to be minimal, other than XFCE uses fewer resources, and Mate is... I mean, it's got a few more features on, but for all intents and purposes, a desktop environment is really just a menu and a window manager and some icons. So, there's that. Anyway, it does look like a solid distribution. The big issue I have with Linux Mint Cinnamon, and it's a pretty big issue. It's not really. It's not a show-stopping issue, but if we go down to the controls, I think it is, and then go into the Mint Y darker theme, and then we go to the window border, Mint Y, I guess we'll go dark. and then you pull up a few windows, you sort of notice that the window window border drawings are not being the window borders are not being drawn. That's what I'm trying to say. Eventually, so as you can see here with the mint wide theme in cinnamon, there's no like borders around the window, so it goes straight into, you know, you could the windows kind of blur in a bit. It'd be nice to have just a one pixel outline of the windows. I think, is there a shadow effect that you could bring in possibly? Some compositing effects maybe. Effects. And do we have shadow effects or anything like that? Effect style. Fancy style? And we can enable customize settings. So there does seem to be a few here. So maybe, you know, you might get some mileage if you had a shadow underneath the window, you know, if you managed to get a shadow up. But that one does seem, it seems a little bit problematic that the Mint Y theme, just, it looks, again, it's a little bit unideal. It's a little bit broken. I wouldn't use a distribution that didn't have a solid board around the windows. It just makes it a little bit more confusing in that department. Allows you to switch to a local mirror. That's pretty good. And then, of course, these are the standard updates that you can expect if you were to install Mate. Not Mate, Cinnamon. Mint Cinnamon. So, that's about my preview of the Linux Mint. I'm just having a look at the wallpapers here. Not much, actually. Disappointing. Oh, here we go. Sorry. Oh, that's a little better. That's better. Yeah. And now I remember these. I remember seeing these from previous versions of Mint, I think, or at least some of them. Yeah, definitely. But they are. They're real nice background desktop wallpapers. So yeah, all in all, pretty solid distribution, but the competition around it is increasingly growing. I really like it. I've always had a lot of respect for Linux Mint. It's managed to add polish to Ubuntu distributions which I feel have been pre-released in the past. And since 16.06 Ubuntu is receiving quite a lot of criticism, there could very well be a beeline for Linux Mint to make into an increasingly popular sphere. Who knows? But it seems pretty solid, barring the occasional theme breakage. Everything else seems pretty on the money. So good work, Linux Mint team. Really like the distribution. It's a solid distribution. It's a staple of the desktop Linux world by now, I expect. At least I see it as that. So excellent. Thanks very much for watching. If you have any thoughts, of course, please leave them down in the comment section below. And until next time, I've been Chris Ware, and you've been awesome. Take care now.